neighbor.
Greetings, greetings, my people. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. It depends where you are watching from. All hail Biafra from my people. Greetings to you all. As you can see, today is a very powerful day because today is one of the D-Day of Abuja Convention, where they do their cankerworms and play their games, try to show the world that they have law, while truly there is no law in that federation. You may ask why appearing this time of the day. I have a special message for you people. You know, news have been flying around, many have been telling their stories, telling you people one thing or the other. Some, even though the former governor of Abia State keep on telling people, so-called Nnamdi Kanu's brothers and relations are telling him that Nnamdi Kanu have traveled out of the country. But the message reaching me now from the right source inside Nigerian High Court in Abuja, the federal government have made it to our notice that Nnamdi Kanu is in their custody. What did I say? Breaking news, Nnamdi Kanu is in the federal government's custody. They did not respect the rule of law of the federation. I am now giving you the direct information from the Nigerian court of law that Nnamdi Kanu is in the custody of the federation. Can you hear that? Oh my God, unbelievable. You will be pressing your people to respect the law of the land while you have no respect for your own laws. That is a lie. Is alarming, because during the time of this current president Buhari, when he was ruling Nigeria before, he keeps on, that is his own normal way of ruling the nation, he never respected the judiciary, the law of the federation. I made it clear before that every Easterner, every Biafran, if you call yourself IPOB, if you see yourself as a Biafran, it is time to start drafting a letter of complain to the Senate, Federal Senate of the country, telling them to press Buhari to respect the rule of law. Can you believe that the Federal High Court Abuja granted Nnamdi Kanu bail, gave him bail, and did not find him any guilty of breaching his bail? But the federal government, the Operation Python Dance they brought to the Eastern region was only to arrest Nnamdi Kanu. Nnamdi did not travel to any country. Nnamdi did not travel to any place. They are spreading this news to calm people down. Nnamdi Kanu is in the custody of the federation. Now, this is the largest, the most ambiguous crime committed in that federation. Why must people respect the rule of law? Why must people follow the right due process? Why the federation shows the people he himself as the federal government doesn't have respect for the rule of law and the judicial system of their own government? Listen, my people, it is time now to demand from the federal government, use every channel in your reach. Tell the federal government to grant, to release the citizen that the federal high court have granted bail. We are not in military regime. We battled Abacha government because we don't want to take any order or killings or this type of attitude from the military. Today we are in civilian rule, and our president thinks that we are still in the uniformed regime. We have to tell him we are not in uniform regime. We are civilians, and the civil law must be respected. The law of the Federation, for now, we are still operating under the Nigerian umbrella. They should release Nnamdi Kanu. They should respect the Federal High Court, the order that the Federal High Court ordered the entire Federation, and release Nnamdi Kanu on bail. The government of Buhari should release Nnamdi Kanu and pay for the reparation of his compound, and pay for the damages of the 28 people they killed in his compound. Did you know that they take the life of up to 28 people? Over 100 and something people wounded on that day. The federal government doesn't want you to know that. They take the life of the ordinary citizens, those they claim they were present to be under their regime, under their government. They killed 28 people on that day. Over 100 and something wounded. And they destroyed Nnamdi Kanu's compound. They burned his cars. They killed the dogs, even the chicken, the fowls that are moving around were gone down. And they pick him up. Whether he's alive, nobody knows. Whether he's dead, nobody knows. But they didn't bring him to court. But they made it to our own understanding that he is in their custody. Why must the ordinary citizens respect the law if the federal government failed to respect their own law, failed to accept the judgment of the Federation? When a judge look into case, investigates the case, and notice there is nothing, this person is not guilty, this person need bail, and they grant him bail, and the federal government send in the military. That means Buhari government doesn't have trust in police, in mobile police, in civil law, in judicial system. He has only trust in his own military. But we say sorry, we are not a military regime, we are a civilian regime. The whole world, the whole Nigeria should stand up to press Buhari to respect the rule of law of the Federation. I'm challenging even though those that call themselves Nigerian, those that find sympathy for us to remain as one. Why don't you stand up now and ask the federal government to release and respect the law of the land? And let's use this opportunity to challenge the Senate of the federal of the Federation to come out and protect the law of the land. It is their duty. The Senate is not there for flower. They are not there for flower. This time is not the time to throw insult. We should not throw insult to nobody. Rather talk sense into them. Rather challenge them by their laws. Senate, you are the lawmakers of the land. If the president cannot respect the law that you have passed that should be operating into the country, who else should he respect that law? Who and who is going to respect that law? Are you creating law for the ordinary masses on the street? Are you people above the law of the Federation? If you are above the law of the Federation, come publicly and made it to our hearing that the laws that you people in Senate and House of Rep are creating is only for the masses, for the ordinary man, for the ordinary poor people on the street, that you people are above the law and you people are not ready and willing to defend and safeguard the law that you have passed into that Federation. Even though you are Yoruba, Hausa, Ibibio, whatever, if you know, because if this thing didn't happen to you today, it got to happen to you tomorrow. And many people are being arrested under this Operation Python dance. There is somebody they call Bright Chimezie. He was picked up and he's nowhere to be found. Many are being picked up without your notice. The federal government should respect the law of the land, and nobody should be above the law, period. We must do something, my people. I keep on telling you people, stay away from fake news. A lot of fake news are flying around, especially on this Facebook. People are sharing things that are not real. Somebody wrote to me, send me something, give me a chamber of lawyers that are taking Nigeria to, that have taken Nigeria to International Criminal Court. All this is a lie. If you go to the International Criminal Court, what you will find there is a case versus Nigeria and Boko Haram, a case Delta Niger Delta versus Nigeria. There is no IPOB, there is no Biafra, there is not even Igbo man versus the Federation. We cannot take Nigeria to court in United States. The United States law blocked such a thing to happen, because if United States allow an individual to sue Nigeria in their court of justice, then they have opened what they call Pandora box. Nigeria can sue the Americans in Nigeria and punish them in Nigeria. So for them to safeguard their own ass, and their companies are committing crime in Nigeria so that they will not be arrested in Nigeria, they are blocking it in the highest level. I shared something on my Facebook. Go and look for it. Washington made it clear, according to their law of 18 something, blocked any individual or any person to sue a federation in their country. That's why I tell you, my people, the only thing we can do is to take Nigeria to International Human Rights Court. Dear Nigeria will answer that court, that case. If you are I cannot take Nigeria to a German court here, Nigeria will not answer, and even the court will throw that case away. Let us stop fooling ourselves. Let us face the reality. Let us start doing something. I tell you, people, support the legal battle. Support us to take Nigeria to International Human Rights Court. We can do it. Nnamdi Kanu is in their custody. We can release him. We can do something. But if you feel like you're only here to listen, to listen, to listen, somebody calls me and tell me, my brother, please, I like stories. Can you tell me a story about Biafra? Are we here to hear stories, or we are here to hear the real information and take precautions to bind the hand of Nigeria? If they cannot respect their law in their own country, then we take them to the international community where they will be able to respect their laws. That's all I have for you today. The information now that just came in, Nnamdi Kanu is in the custody of the Federation. Thank you, and God bless you.
One day Ikwere na Biafra, Biafra we meri. Ikwere na Biafra, we derumo faka genu.
Ikwere na Biafra, Biafra, Biafra. Ikwere na Biafra, we derumo faka genu.
Hey, Ikwere na Biafra, Biafra we meri. Ikwere na Biafra, we derumo faka genu.
Ikwere na Biafra, Biafra, Biafra.
Adomina, Adomina, oh,
Adomina, 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 Adomina.
Adomina, Adomina, oh,
Adomina.